Hi there. In today's video, I'm going to show you how to digitize your physical hand-drawn sketches and artwork directly onto your iPad using Procreate. So this video is part one of a two-part series. First, we'll import your hand-drawn lettering or illustrations into Procreate, and I'll guide you through refining them and cleaning them up. Then in the second video, I'll show you the exact steps to convert your polished artwork into a vector format using a completely free autotrace method. So this way your designs will be ready to use in apps like Affinity Designer, Linearity Curve, or Adobe Illustrator. If we haven't met before, hi, my name is Nicole from iPad Calligraphy, where I teach curious creatives how to use the iPad for lettering and design. Whether you're digitizing quick sketchbook doodles or intricate designs, I'll walk you step by step through getting your physical art from paper onto the iPad. Digitizing your artwork has a ton of benefits. Personally, my main motivation is preservation, especially with a four-year-old who's particularly adventurous with crayons. But there's lots of other benefits too, like recoloring, repurposing, and scaling. And stick around because one of my most favorite tips you'll definitely want to see, a quick trick to easily separate your line work from the background in fewer than three taps. This makes recoloring or changing backgrounds incredibly easy with no tedious retracing required. So if you're ready, let's get started. Keen-eyed among you may have noticed my cool new iPad case. I'm trying out the MOFT Dynamic Folio. The case folds like origami, and there's these little icons on the back of the lid that you align, and it snaps and locks the iPad into different positions. You can choose from several floating angles depending on how you want to use your iPad, whether it's for scrolling, reading, or drawing. You can even flip the screen around really easily to share your screen with someone sitting across from you, which is pretty cool. There's also a flap on the back where you can tuck the lid to set it in an 80-degree reading mode. My favorite setup, though, is what they call dual screen drawing mode. So if you flip the case into the tilted drawing position, there's a small platform at the top where you can rest your phone, and the magnets keep it stable so you can watch tutorials, course lessons, or even stream TV while you draw without worrying about your phone sliding off. I know my iPad calligraphy students would really love this for following along with their practice videos. There's also a detachable Apple Pencil holder that clips onto the back of the iPad. The only downside with this, though, is it keeps the pencil charging whenever it's attached. Personally, I think the pencil's lifespan is going to be better if you only charge it as needed. But overall, I'm really enjoying this new addition to my creative setup, so thank you, MOFT. And back to the video. Here's the artwork I'll be working with today. As you can see, it's a simple black and white sketch. I created it using a micron pen on tracing paper, and I've just placed a plain white sheet of paper underneath, which will help me make sure that the background looks completely white when I photograph it. So I'm just using my iPhone to take the photo, and to get a sharp image, I just tap and hold on the screen to lock the focus, and that way the sketch stays perfectly in focus. I usually take one or two photos to just make sure I have a good option to work with. So I've just airdropped my photo from my phone and saved it in my Photos app. Now I'll open Procreate and create a new canvas. I'm creating the canvas at 3000 by 3000 pixels, and I'm going to make sure it's 300 dpi. This size is then large enough for printing and gives flexibility if you want to resize it later. So now I'll insert the photo. Just tap the wrench icon, which is the Actions menu, choose Add, and then Insert a Photo. So you can just select your photo from the library here. Once inserted, Procreate automatically activates the Transform tool, and I'll rotate using the 45-degree Rotate button in this bottom menu, just tapping it a few times until it's facing the right way. Without deselecting, I'll scale up slightly so the floral elements touch the corners, and it's okay if they clip a little off the canvas. We want to avoid deselecting before we've finished transforming the image, and this is because each time you rotate or resize, Procreate slightly reduces the image quality. To preserve the best quality, try to complete all your adjustments like that in one go before confirming the transformation. This will just keep the quality as good as it can be. Okay, so once positioned, I'll tap the arrow tool to commit the change. Procreate will clip the image to the canvas size once you confirm. So next, let's adjust the contrast to give the image a really crisp black and white, which will help us in those next vector phases. Head to the adjustments menu, which is the magic wand icon, and choose hue, saturation, and brightness. So make sure layer is selected in this top little arrow menu and not pencil. It should default to layer anyway though, but just so you know, that's there. We'll slightly increase the saturation and also the brightness, and this brightens the whites and deepens the blacks. So apply the changes by tapping on the middle of the screen and select apply. This menu is handy. It also allows you to preview your changes, or you can cancel too. Now open curves, which is also under the adjustments menu. Curves lets us fine tune the contrast even further. So make sure gamut is selected, and you can pull the points gently until you just get a clean black and white result with minimal paper texture showing. Just make sure you're not losing any of the actual artwork details. Once you're happy with the changes, just tap the adjustments menu again to apply it. So at this point, we can take a closer look at the artwork. If you notice any gaps or imperfections, now's a great time to fix those. For example, I'm going to fill this small gap here near the letter D. If I choose my selection tool from the top menu, that's the one that looks like a little S, I'm going to make sure I'm in freehand mode just in the bottom menu, and I can now draw around the element, and then I'll three-finger swipe on the canvas, choose copy, and then three-finger swipe again and choose paste. And this creates a new layer with the copied piece. So using the arrow tool, I can reposition and rotate the element into place. So I'm happy that looks good there and fills that gap. Now I'm going to pinch those two layers together to merge them so that there's just one main artwork layer. Now I want to just clean up and fill a couple of areas that didn't completely fill with the black pen. So we're working with black and white. I'm going to show you a little trick to easily swap between those two colors. All you need to do is tap your color circle, and from the disc panel down the bottom, just double tap the color disc near the black area, and this will snap right to the rim, and that gives you pure black. Next, we're going to do the same for the wipes. So just double tap the color disc area near the white, and that will snap to pure white. Now you can quickly swap between these two colors just by tapping and holding the color circle. It then switches to your last used color, and that's super handy and allows you to just move really fast when you're recoloring with two colors like this. So I'm going to select my monoline brush. You can use any brush really, but just make sure it's got no texture to it. I'm going to fill in any areas that are missing so they're more solid black. And you can also paint over unwanted artifacts with white just to get rid of them and smooth out the shapes. This isn't about perfection, it's just a basic cleanup before vectorizing. And if you're only planning to work inside Procreate and not joining us for part two of vectorizing this, then you could spend longer here on this stage. But vectorizing should do a bit of this work for us, so we don't have to worry too much. So the next part is optional, but I'm going to add a frame to just finish the design off nicely. I'll create a new layer above the artwork by tapping the plus icon in the top right of the layer panel. And I'm using a stamp brush from my Shapes and Ornaments pack. It's called the Scalloped Frame Outline Brush. I'm just going to stamp roughly in the center. It doesn't have to be perfect right now, as long as it's about the same size and it was stamped within the canvas. So use the arrow tool, and if you turn on snapping in this bottom menu, it will snap to the center of the canvas for you. So you can just see this orange line when it snaps into position on both the horizontal and the vertical axis. I'm just going to erase any overlaps now between the frame and the artwork so it gives it a clean look. And now, as promised, I'm going to show you one of my favorite tips, and that's how to separate line work from your background if you're just using one flat layer. So this is super useful. If you're not vectorizing, it makes it easy to change the color of the line work and the background independently. So first tap the artwork layer to select it, and then tap it again and choose mask from the flyout menu. So masks work in black and white. And a good way to remember how they behave is the phrase white reveals,
black conceals. Right now, the mask is white, meaning everything on the layer is fully visible. If I switch to pure black, and I'll paint over that part of the artwork, and because it's in black, that section will now be hidden, but it's not deleted. If I tap the little tick box on the mask, which turns off its visibility, you'll see that the original artwork is still there underneath. So the mask just simply hides parts of it without erasing anything. And first, we're just going to select the artwork layer and then tap again and choose copy. Then tap the mask layer to select it. It should appear in blue. And we're going to three finger swipe on the screen and then choose paste. Because the line work is currently black and the background is white, pasting it onto the mask actually hides the line work. And that's the opposite of what we want. So to fix this, just simply tap on the mask layer and choose invert. This flips the black and white, making the black line work visible and the background hidden. So you'll see now if I change my background color, you can see that we've got the line work available separately now. So your line work and your background are separated and you can easily change the color of the background. And you can also recolor the line work itself by filling the layer with the new color, and the mask will reveal the artwork. So you can now change those two colors independently now. Okay, so you have a fully digitized version of your artwork in Procreate. If you're happy with it as it is and that's all you need, you can stop here. But if you'd like to take it a step further, in the next video, I'll show you how to convert your pixel artwork from Procreate into vector format quickly, easily, and completely for free. I'll show you a workaround for when your artwork is full color, not just black and white. Thanks for following on today. I hope it was helpful, and I'll see you in the next video.